Steve Perry. He's currently climbing the music charts with his first solo album. And as the lead singer for Journey, one of the most popular bands in the world, he's subject to a tremendous amount of pressure. Pressure to perform, to tour, to write, and produce top-notch albums. But he says he wouldn't give up being a journeyman just because of a little tension.
Day-to-day life is a pressure situation as it is, and I do the best I can to handle that. The business I'm in creates its own compounds. I wouldn't change, you know, what I've done. I really am glad what I've accomplished. But there is an awful lot of things that come along with something that you don't know about till you get there, you know. No matter if you're a lawyer or whatever, you study in school, but until you get in there, you start, you know, going through your moves. There's adversities that come with every profession that you don't know about until they hit you in the face. But overall, you know, it's a positive thing. It really is more positive than negative, or I wouldn't be here.
Escape was the title of Journey's 1981 platinum LP, and it's also something lead singer Steve Perry says he needs to do more of.
There's more than just beat your brains away and lock yourself in a little box and record an album forever and get that studio tan that's somewhere between white and gray. I have a lot to learn about what to do with relaxing and where to do it. I mean, how to do it. I really got to tell you, it's going to be one of my major chores to try to slow the wheels down a little bit, because they roll too fast, I think. Too fast.
Even if he thinks his wheels are rolling mighty quickly down the career track, Steve Perry is at least on the right track. The most recent Journey album, Frontiers, followed its predecessors into the million-selling Hall of Vinyl. And Steve Perry co-wrote a song from Frontiers that was number one in the spring of 1983, Separate Ways, Worlds Apart.
That song is a very powerful song about a breakup situation, but in a positive way, you know. Most breakups, love relationships, when they break up, they really explode. They terminate in a very bad way. The original premise of that song was that it's better that that this happened, because someday love will find you, and you'll be free and you'll be happy, which obviously this situation couldn't give you.
Street Talk. That's the title of Steve Perry's debut solo album. But it doesn't consist of songs he's been saving for years and years and years.
I collaborated with a lot of people on it, but it hasn't been 6 years of stashing songs. This album was written in 3 weeks. It was rehearsed in 4 days. Basics were done in 8, and overdubs were done 6 hours a day for about 3-4 weeks later. And then mixing. It was done relatively quick.
The idea behind recording his solo LP in a short period of time, says Steve Perry, was to bring out a certain amount of spontaneity, what he calls an honest approach.
When you walk into a studio, the sky's the limit. If you want to, you can make a silk purse out of a sow's ear. You really can. And then again, you can use that same medium to truly capture something that feels great to your advantage, as opposed to water it down a bit. I really didn't want to do anything like water down any of the spontaneity that my album had to offer. There's some really honest-to-goodness performance and different vocal styles that I really, really like to do.
And while we're in the honesty department, Steve Perry says even though his companion, Sherry, has the honor of being the inspiration for the first hit from his solo album, she freely admits there's another tune she likes even more than Oh, Sherry.
She's truthful. Sherry's truthful. I mean, she's not going to lie to me. She loves the song, and she's very, you know, happy and very flattered that there's a song there. It's a real nice thing, and she does like the song, but she's being very truthful that her favorite song is Foolish Heart. I mean, she's got to be honest. What else can she do?
Foolish Heart, the song Sherry honestly thinks is the best one on Steve Perry's Street Talk LP, is a ballad about love and how difficult it is balancing emotion with reason.
It's really a head-heart conflict. Your heart always wants to do what it wants to do, you know, and your logic says not to do. Mainly, this is mainly about falling in love or not to fall back in love again. And your heart obviously wants to give it a shot, but your logic says it hurts too much and I'm not into it. So it's a head and heart conflict. But inevitably, the heart always wins and you're always in a painful situation or some sort of an unpredictable situation. So it really is a head and heart conflict. The heart's winning.
Steve Perry co-wrote all 10 songs on his solo album, and he's also responsible for co-writing many of Journey's biggest hits. To create those chart toppers, he says he needs some hustle and bustle around. No quiet, poetic, solitary corners for him.
The best thing for me to be, you know, creatively, the condition-wise, is to be in a city, for instance, like Los Angeles. Maybe a funky environment. You can't really sit in a studio environment and write songs. I don't believe in that. I don't know. It's just like the dentist office or something like that. It is definitely something when you touch it with your finger, you can feel it. It's exciting, too. Very exciting, that creative thing.
Steve Perry used his imagination to create an entire scenario in song on his solo album. In the tune She's Mine, the main character is a very protective spouse.
She's Mine. It's about a gentleman that seen around his home where his wife is home all day being a housewife. And this guy knows that this guy cruising around his house is a womanizer. And he says, I've seen you creeping around. I've seen your kind before, you know. Most womanizers like this do have sort of a gigolo spell that they can cast on women sometimes. And the man just says, look, you just better back off because this one's mine. You know, stay away from my door. I don't want to see you around here no more. I know you'd like her at your hotel, but not as long as I'm alive. You know, I'm one of those kind of... It's really... he's pretty uptight, this guy. The voice in this particular song is pretty angry. So he's telling this guy a certain message. He's poking a finger at his chest, definitely.
I Believe is a song on Steve Perry's Street Talk LP that deals with a different aspect of love, and it also represents quite another musical style.
I Believe is a positive song, real positive, about the confusing things of love. If you feel love's an illusion, you know, all the confusions. But I believe in you and me, you know, it's a real positive statement. Plus, I really, really went for some... unique rhythms on that song that I really wanted to try.
Steve Perry believes in love and in taking chances. And taking chances is just what he sings about in a song on his Street Talk album called Running Alone.
It's a strong statement about not being afraid to go out on your own. And in light of the success or failure that you could have, you know, the old turtle gets nowhere until the neck comes out of his shell. He can't go forward, you know, he just sits there with his neck in. So you got to stick your neck out and try sometimes. And if you don't try, nothing happens. So you can't be afraid to run alone, you know. You can't be afraid to lose. You can't be afraid of being alone. Although, hey, I'm right there, too. I mean, these questions come to me. I mean, who wants to be alone and who wants to fail?
I don't mind running.